Hello, welcome to week 6 of Pick 3 DST, where I give you 3 defenses I like and 1 defense I want you to stay away from. As always, I do these videos every single week, so please make sure to click the link to subscribe to get this video and all of our other Rotoballer content. We do waiver wire videos, we do weekly start sit videos, we do DFS videos, so hit that subscribe button to get all of that content every single week. If you're looking for my weekly defense rankings, make sure to click the link below the video, and that will take you to the rankings for the entire week, as well as a link to the leaderboard that I will update as the week goes on in case of injuries, weather, etc. So let's get this started with my stud option for the week. It's no surprise, it's the Los Angeles Rams. They are 8th overall for me. That's in the 8th best BOD, best overall defense, but they are my first ranked defense for this week. They are 5th in QB hurry rate. They are 5th in pressure rate. I think those are really sticky stats that help to tell us the success of a defense long-term, and they're facing the Giants. Without Saquon Barkley, without Kenny Golladay, potentially without Darius Slayton, Sterling Shepard, potentially without Daniel Jones, which means they get Mike Glennon, I want to attack this matchup. The Rams are far and away my number one defense for this week. My solid option is the Dallas Cowboys. They are the 6th best BOD for me in the season, but they are my 3rd ranked defense for this week. They're middle in the pack of pressure rate, but that's okay because they're 2nd in the NFL in percentage of defensive drives that result in an offensive turnover. Everybody's already talking about Diggs and how great he is on defense. This is causing a lot of turnovers and a lot of fantasy points for the Dallas defense. They're also going up against the New England Patriots, who are 5th worst in the NFL in points allowed to opposing fantasy defenses. It is a matchup I want to attack. I do not think the Patriots are very good. The Cowboys are going to score a lot, force Mac Jones to pass to catch up. It's going to lead to turnovers and points. My sleeper defense for the week is the Green Bay Packers. They're 9th in my season-long rankings, and they're 7th for me this week. They are 6th in drives that end in an offensive turnover, so they're a little below the Cowboys, but that's still good because, again, they're another average pressure rate defense, but their pass rush has improved a lot of late. They are facing the Bears, who are 29th in the NFL and have allowed 18 sacks over the first 5 games. So even with an average pass rush, I think they can take advantage of this matchup. The Bears coaching staff is not doing anything different with Justin Fields. They're not designing runs for him or RPOs. They're not really pushing the ball downfield. So I don't really think that this is a matchup where they're going to exploit the Packers' loss of Jair Alexander. And then my stay-away defense for the week is the Miami Dolphins. They are 30th for me on the season, 30th BOD ranking, and they're 14th for me in the week. So it's not a terrible defense, but I see a lot of people having them in the top 10. I'm just not going there. They're bottom third in pressure rate. They are dead last, worst in the NFL in QB hurry rate, and they're middle of the pack in turnovers. Last year, they were at the top of the league in turnovers per game, which was helping to cover up the flaw that they didn't get after the quarterback a lot. Now they don't get after the quarterback a lot and are not getting a lot of turnovers. So the fantasy points have not been there. Jacksonville has weapons on offense with James Robinson, LaVisca Chenault, Marvin Jones Jr. I know it's not a great offense, but it's not as bad an offense as it was last year. Their offensive line is playing better, and I don't really think this is a matchup where the Dolphins are going to have a huge week. So we're going to have them 14th. They're not horrible, but it's not a defense that I'm going out and aggressively targeting. Again, reminder to click the subscribe button so you can get this video every single week. And make sure you talk to me in the comments below. Let me know what defense you're rocking with this week. Good luck in week 6.